it's out of standing.
It's not every day we have Dennis Quaid on the couch.
I know.
Welcome.
Welcome.
How does it feel to be here? Your mom watches every morning?
Yeah, she's out there right now.
Oh. Where does she watch from?
She's in Austin, Texas.
Nice.
Where'd you grow up?
She lives in a retirement home. I grew up in Houston, and this movie, I can only imagine. One of the things that really drew me to it, too, is I know those people. It takes place in East Texas. He was born in Greenville, Bart was. And so I just know these people. And so it was an easy fit for me.
Bart's the lead singer of Mercy Me.
Right.
Did the whole group come together there in East Texas?
Yes, I think there and around, you know, from there to Oklahoma City. He actually came into the group after they had formed a group. I think they were looking for a singer.
Yeah.
And
You know, I love the Lord, and I grew up in churches, and it's very important in my life. When this song came out, I was like, well, I love this song. And then you turn on a secular radio station. Like, the number one station growing up was 104.7 in my hometown. And secular music, no Christian music. And this was number one.
Right.
It was played over and over. And I was like, God, you are so good. This song is touching the lives of so many people.
And, other charts, and, you know, worldwide, really. And I think the reason that it does, you know, whether you're a Christian or not, is that you hear the song and it hits you. It hits it, people make it personal about their own lives, and it hits you in a place where you have no words. But and it's a song of joy.
Do you ever think about the impact you're going to make? This movie's it's going to change lives.
Well, it's we wanted to get it right for Bart. Bart is the one who's really making the impact. It was very brave of him to tell his story to begin with. And it's we got it right for him, so he says. And so we're already a success.
So you're filming in the North Pole?
Yeah, I'm on my way to Svalbard. It's the northernmost inhabitable place on Earth.
Did you see Santa up there anywhere?
It's where Perry landed. You could put his boat and he could walk the 200 miles
left
of the North Pole. Oh, well, today it's 45. It's warmer there than it is here.
Really?
It's 45 degrees above what it's supposed to be.
That's so if you're going to film the North Pole, you go when it's warm, right?
Yeah.
As warm
no,
as possible.
But it's 1,000 people and 3,000 polar bears. And it's going to be an adventure.
You're, wait, 3,000 polar bears?
To be exact. Yeah.
Are you in danger?
I don't know. They're auditioning for a Coca-Cola commercial.
Right. That's funny. What's your favorite movie you ever did?
That I ever did? Mm-hmm. Is The Right Stuff.
Why?
Well, because I'm playing an astronaut. And
Gordon Cooper.
Gordo Cooper, who was my favorite astronaut as a kid, by the way, in Houston, which was Space City. And I got my pilot's license in that movie. And Chuck Yeager was on the set every day. It's like, you know, walking, talking icon.
That's very cool.
And it took 9 months to shoot. And it was, I was so sad when it was over. It was a great movie.
Well, Brian had to leave to go do radio, but he was telling us his favorite was Frequency.
Yeah,
what was that like?
Which is another father-son story. We shot right here in New York City. And, you know, I'm a sucker for those.
How'd you go from Texas to making it on the big screen, becoming so famous?
Well, I was just going to be an actor, and I wanted to do movies, and you can't do that. You couldn't do that in Houston.
Right.
So I moved out there and just got a job.
And out to Hollywood?
I got another job, and, you know, it's had a great capacity to hear the word no a lot until I heard a yes.
Do you have any advice for people growing up now who are trying to do the same thing that you were able to do?
It's basically the same. What I tell my kids is find something that you love to do, very passionate about, and then figure out a way to get paid for it.
Right. Because
you have a good portion of your life solved. You'll never work, but you have to be. If you're gonna go out there, you've gotta be very, very passionate about it, and you've gotta be dogged in to hear the word no a lot. But I do it because I love it.
Well, you're very good at it.
I have more fire in my belly now than I did in my 20s.
Wow.
Well, it's such an honor to sit here and talk to you. We've watched you on the big screen for so long. Now you're here in person.
Well, it's the first time I've been on this couch. You can't believe it.
Well, you're welcome anytime. And so
is
your mom.
All right.
Hi, Mom.
Have a great weekend, everyone. We'll see you on Monday.